Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing five quick and easy hairstyles that you can do with second day hair. Even if your hair is freshly washed, you can do it. I would just suggest using some dry shampoo or something like that, just so your hair can hold the updo or whatever you are doing. I really find that my hair holds a curl and holds hairstyles a lot easier when it is a little bit dirty as opposed to freshly washed. I usually wash my hair the day before and curl it however I'm gonna wear it, and then the next day that is when I'll do these hairstyles, just so I don't have to wake up extra early and curl my hair or anything like that. You don't have to curl your hair, but the hairstyles do look better and they hold better when your hair is already curled. Unless you have some natural waviness or texture or something to your hair, then you should be good. Oh yeah, and sorry if I sound disgusting. I am pretty sick, but I just wanted to film a video because I won't be able to film a video until the end of this week, and I did not want to not be posting videos. I did kind of want to put a variety in there, so a couple of the hairstyles are more put together, so if you have to be at work or a meeting or something like that, these ones are perfect for you, and then I do have some other laid-back ones. So if you really don't have anywhere to be, but you just want to kind of throw something together and not look like the grouch that just crawled out of the garbage can, then these ones will be for you too. Really quick, I did want to mention that towards the end of September, I will be starting my Halloween makeup tutorials. I'm super excited. Ever since I started watching YouTube videos, Halloween makeup tutorials and hair tutorials and everything like that was my favorite things to watch. So for the whole month of October, it's pretty much going to be Halloween videos. And I'm already starting to plan those out, and I have four Halloween looks that I'm going to be posting. So make sure you keep an eye out for those, because I'm super excited for Halloween. Thumbs up this video if you are excited for Halloween. I absolutely love Halloween. Even if I'm not doing anything for Halloween, I actually think I have school on Halloween, but I'm just super excited, and I like the fact that I can post makeup tutorials and stuff like that on YouTube, because I can kind of have like a bunch of Halloweens because I'm dressing up in videos. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure to thumbs up this video and like and subscribe and everything like that if you want to see more. If you have any video requests, leave them in the description box. If you have any video requests, leave them in the comments below, and I will see you in my next video. Bye! Have you ever woken up and had to be somewhere, but you didn't have time to wash your hair? I recommend not brushing your hair when you have some leftover curls in there. I'm just going to show you five easy hairstyles that I always do when I'm in a rush and I don't have time. So the first thing that I'm doing is picking up the top section of my hair and using some hairspray by Pureology and just teasing at the root. I'm doing two sections in the crown and then one on each side of my head, just so it's all even. We all American. Yeah, I said party over here, call up everybody we know. This is for the women who be feeding off my ego. Tell them that I made it, cause I listened to my haters, took what they said and negated. Yeah, I played it like I'm T-Bow. Pour me out another one, take a shot and reload. Girls be waiting for me, got them lining up like free throws. Everywhere that we go, they say I'm their favorite, but I see that you've been faking, baby. I know how to. Next, I'm pinning up the two side sections with bobby pins just to create some volume. You can leave your bangs out depending on how short or long they are. Here's the view of the back just so you can see a little bit better. Then you want to gather all your hair into a low ponytail. The higher on the head you have your ponytail, the higher your bun is going to be. This is where your curls come in handy because it really helps the hair bend and stay how it is. And then if pieces come out, it doesn't look as weird. So the first thing that I'm doing is sectioning my hair. I'm probably going to do about four sections. If you have thicker hair, it might be a little bit more. But I'm just taking the hair and wrapping it around itself and then pinning it into place. It's really not going to look the same every time you do it, just because you're going to put the hair in different places each time, and you kind of want it to be messy and undone. I like to leave the ends kind of loose, just because I think it adds to the updo. Don't be afraid to keep bobby pinning it into place, because you really want it to hold all day. Take a shot and reload. Girls be waiting for me, got them lining up like free throws. Everywhere that we go, they say I'm their favorite, but I see that you've been faking, baby. I know how to make it in America, doing what we love and we passionate. Yo, girl is cashing in, Kourtney Kardashian. You pulled up with some honeybees and I pulled out with half of them, cause I ain't going home if I ain't going with the baddest chick. Thumbs up to my friends drinking whiskey, peace out to the girls that don't miss me. So that is look number one, and I really like this look, and I think it's perfect for a day at work or something where you have to look a little bit more put together. Don't forget to hairspray it, and then I like to pull some pieces out around the sides of my face just so it's not all slicked back. Another tip I have to dressing up yourself when your hair is up is to add some earrings. These ones are from Charlotte Russe. Something you could do to all these hairstyles, or any hairstyle that you want to do, is add some dry shampoo. It really soaks up any extra oil, and it also creates some hold for your hair. This next look is more laid back. I'm just clipping in some Bellami hair extensions. These are the Piccolina extensions, 18 inches. I think this is the Dirty Blonde color. I do have a coupon code, so if you are interested, that will all be in the description box below. Obviously, some days I don't have time to clip in extensions, but with this specific hairstyle, I do like to add some length and volume. This is the only hairstyle that I do clip in extensions with in this video, and if you don't have extensions, then just skip this step. So for this, you want to make sure you have a side part, and then I just take a section from my bangs, divide it into three sections, and then start to French braid. If you don't know how to French braid, you just take the outside section and overlap it into the middle section, and then keep going with that, and then just keep adding hair in from the outside and putting it over the middle. It's really hard to explain French braiding, so you could just watch what I'm doing. This is a Dutch braid, so instead of going over the middle, I'm going under the middle, and that is what makes the braid look more 3D. Once you get about an inch down, you want to keep adding hair from the back of your head. You eventually want all the hair incorporated into the braid. It's going to start on the front of your head by your bangs and then incorporate all your hair. So just keep taking sections from the back and adding it into the side of your hair. Once you run out of hair to add in, you're just going to continue as a normal braid, but make sure you keep overlapping it underneath instead of over, just to have that 3D effect. Be bagging groceries or trying to sell insurance, but it's right here a short thing. You wake up with nothing on your plate, oh you poor thing, cause I did what I want and I made my dreams reality. These bitches be kicking off what I'm making like Sara Lee. Looking through my yearbook, said I would succeed quick, throwing out my salary cause I don't ever need shit. Thumbs up to my friends drinking whiskey, to the girls that don't miss me, middle finger to the dudes back in high school, cause you peaked at 18, cool, oh, oh, cause you peaked at 18, cool, oh, oh, you make me look so good. 4 years gone by, look back and you out of your prime, but the cool kid's never gonna miss me. It's all history, it's all history. 4 years, denied. Fuck that, let's party tonight. So I like to leave about 1 to 1.5 inches at the bottom just so it looks more laid back and you have more room to pull your braid apart. I'm just tying it off with a clear elastic. I think it looks a lot better than having a black one or a big bulky one at the bottom. Next, I'm pulling it apart, so I'm starting at the bottom and just pulling all the way up to the top. I like my braids pretty loose, so I'm really tugging on it and making sure that it's kind of all uneven and loose. The key to pulling your braid apart is making sure that you pull on opposite sides. And then once again, I'm pulling out some hair around my face. I very rarely have a hairstyle where I don't pull my hair out around my face. So that is the finished braid, and I think that it looks very bohemian. Don't take the braid out yet, because for the third hairstyle, all you want to do is take that same braid and just start wrapping it around itself. You want to pin as you go, just so it stays in place, and I'm literally just wrapping it in a circle and pinning it together. And it looks a lot better when the braid is pulled apart, because it kind of just looks like a bun with the big braid on the side. And I think this also looks really bohemian, and I love how big the braid is on the side. So that is the braided updo, and I absolutely love this hairstyle, but sometimes you just want to be more casual. So this next one is just my bun that I always do. Everyone always compliments me on this bun, and it's super easy. All I do is put my hair in a ponytail and then wrap the hair around itself, kind of like a ballerina bun, and then secure it off with a hair tie and pull it apart. It's kind of like a top knot in a way, but it's more pulled apart. So how I get its shape is I just pull and twist and then pin it into place however I like it. This bun is different every single time I do it, and sometimes it takes me 2 or 3 times to get it how I like it. So just keep playing with it and keep molding it into what you want it to look like. Once again, pull some hair out around the side, and I like to kind of pull at the ponytail too, just so it kind of gives me more volume by my head and it's not so tight to my head. There's no test drive, grab your girl and let's ride, take you where I'm supposed to be, because I'll be back to earth someday, and you'll be bagging groceries or trying to sell insurance. But it's right here a short thing, you wake up with nothing on your plate, oh you poor thing, because I did what I want and I made my dreams reality. These bitches be kicking off what I'm making like Sarah Lee, looking through my yearbook, said I would succeed quick, throwing out my salary because I don't ever need shit. Thumbs up to my. This last one is the easiest hairstyle. I actually like this hairstyle with straight hair better, but if you have curly hair, then you just work with what you got. So I'm just putting it in a ponytail, and I like to loosen it up around my face, and sometimes I even tease the crown a little bit, just so it's really loose and big and voluminous. And then I take a section from the back and start wrapping it around the base of the ponytail just to cover up that rubber band. And then I just pin it with a bobby pin, and you might want to use 2 bobby pins for this one. You can just crisscross them in the back, and then I just pull some hair out around the sides. So I hope you guys enjoyed these hairstyles, and be sure to send me pictures on my Twitter and Instagram if you try out any of these, and I hope that I helped you on your days that you are in a rush. Thanks for watching. Bye. They say I'm their favorite, but I see that you've been faking, baby. I know how to make it in America.